Good evening and welcome to the 2022 Homecoming Coronation. My name is Philip Dykow.
My name is Diana Escobar. We are happy to announce that we will be your MCs for the night. Before we dive into the festivities, let's meet our homecoming court. Our crown bearers are Jada Wolf, daughter of Tara and Scott Wolf, and Mason Rojas, son of Felicia and Omar Rojas.
Escorted by Miguel Torres, son of Melissa and Miguel Torres.
Now for the sophomores. Grace Backstrom, daughter of Amanda and Kevin Backstrom, escorted by Benny Ecker, son of Nicole and Brian Ecker. Escorted by Braden Weiss, son of Sarah and Mike Weiss. Daughter of Jenna and Rodolfo Nava, escorted by Parker Sanchez, son of Erica and Fred Sanchez. By Ian Fay, son of Jessica and Jason Fay.
Thank you. congratulations to the members of the 2022 Homecoming Court. Thank you guys, all the friends and family who were able to be here. Really just is a great way to kick off a great homecoming week, and it's going to be a fun time. So, yeah, I guess this homecoming, my theme, what I'm asking everyone to do is to be real. And I don't mean the social media app. If any of you guys are older than 18 and don't know Be Real, it's the new social media app. So your kids are not on Instagram anymore, they're on Be Real. But anyway, so I had the opportunity to see the student council working hard on this theme here, Hollywood glamour, and they did a great job. But then I felt kind of awkward because Hollywood's kind of the center place for not being real, right? Like the center place for acting like somebody you're not in order to fit in order to get ahead. So what I'm asking for us to do today is embrace the glamour of Hollywood, but avoid the part that is not real. So yeah, that's what I'm looking to do. Let's look at the first thing that I want to bring up here as we talk about being real. Two questions for you guys. One, are you striving to be the best version of yourself? I'm asking you, Parker. No, I'm not. I'm just kidding. No, I'm at, are you striving to be the best version of yourself? And are you cultivating or growing meaningful friendships? So those are the two questions I want you to answer for yourself right now. And it's students, it's adults, it's Mr. Hungry back there, it's all of them. So are you striving to be the best version of yourself? And are you cultivating meaningful friendships? How many of you have heard the saying, high school is the best years of your life? It's not. Okay, it's not. Like, wouldn't that be awkward if it was? Like, that would be terrible. Like, I'm 19, guess I gotta get a 9-to-5, go camping every other year, maybe go to the Bahamas when I'm 50. No, that's not it. So high school is the best years of your life. That is not true. But what is true is that your life is substantially better when you're doing those two things. When you're striving to be the best version of yourself and you're making meaningful friendships. And I was dogging on high school a little bit earlier, but what high school can do is provide avenues for you to do these two things. The activities you're in, the classes you're in, those are opportunities for you to get better, right? Academically, athletically. And they're also an avenue to create great friendships that'll last for the rest of your life. So we're going to use these two questions to talk about just a little bit further about how we're doing in our life. So if we sneak to the next slide, let's talk about the first one a little bit. So when it comes to improving yourself, where are you going to go for guidance? And I guess the quote that I have up there that's I'm really guiding my principles on is, compare yourself to who you were yesterday, not to who somebody else is today. That's a quote by Jordan Peterson, and it's a pretty modern quote, but what it is it's a timeless framework for the way that we can act as we go forward in our life and the challenges that we may face. Because at some point, we're gonna be looking for help. Where can we go to get better? One place that we can go is we can go online. So there's a way that you can go online, or you can look for it the real way. The online way, what you can do is you can look on social media apps, right? You can look at Snapchat, Instagram, Be Real. Who am I supposed to be? But that can be pretty problematic, okay? So what's problematic about the online way, Mr. Hubbard? What is problematic about the online way? Yeah, all of a sudden what you do is you start subconsciously comparing yourself to somebody else. So here's an example. Me versus Cristiano Ronaldo. All I can think of is three things. I'll never have as much money as him, I'll never be as athletic as him, and I'll never have that hairline, that's for sure. And so, just like that, if you're on social media, from the comfort of your own home, you are thrown into that world that is the worst of what Hollywood is the comparison game, right? So what I hope you do is I hope you avoid that. I hope you look for the real way to try and better yourself. And what that is it's comparing yourself to who you were yesterday. Here's an example of that on the right. If you can see that picture, the picture on the left is a picture of me in eighth grade, right after I won a math tournament. I was pretty proud. Mrs. Petznick took that picture, if you're here today, Mrs. Petznick. Yep, you heard, she did. But I'm pretty proud of what has happened in the last 10 years. And what that should do is it should give you a bit of motivation to think, hey, what about the next 10 years and the next 10 years? And that's a lifelong process of getting better. So always be striving to get better and compare yourself to who you were yesterday, not to somebody else today. Secondly and lastly, I want you to cultivate real friendships. And so when I say cultivate, that's kind of a weird word. Anyone in here got a better word like than cultivate? Any FFA people up here? Nah. Blake, what do you know? Yeah, it's basically to grow, right? So here's a quote by nobody important. This is actually my quote. It's not very good, but farm friendships so that one day when you are starving, you can harvest. It's kind of weird. I mean, it's not like the best quote ever, but I grew up on a farm. The idea was you had to farm something so that at the end of the year you had a harvest, right? So when it comes to building friendships, there's also two ways that you can try to build friendships, okay? There's the online way, and there's the real way. So the problem with the online way is it's superficial. You're on social media apps. You're liking pictures. You're reacting, commenting, right? And that's kind of like playing Heyday, now that you think about it. If any of you guys have played Heyday, you know what I'm talking about? Heyday. So online friends are kind of like online food. If you haven't played Heyday before, you can like make butter, make like grow corn, whatever you want to do. But then like if you get hungry one day, you're going to need to go eat real food. You're going to need to go to your fridge, the grocery store, something where you actually get real food. So making online friends, you're going to come up hungry when that time comes where you need something more. So the real way is joining an activity, putting your phone down at school and talking to somebody, and making some, I would say memories, but I put a strike through that because making some friends. And so when you're allowed to make friends, what that does, if it's a true friend, you can get in a moment with them, and if you're having a terrible day, or maybe you're having a great day, they can be next to you and understand exactly how you're feeling because you have that extra bond that's much further than anything that can be made in an online way. And so cultivating friendships is really important so that whenever you need them, they can be right by your side. So with that, I just want to finish here by saying, once again, are you striving to be the best version of yourself? Are you cultivating or growing meaningful friendships? I also want to say embrace what this school has to offer for you guys, okay? Use this week and this school as an avenue for you to do these two things, to get better and to make great friends. Go to Zorba's tonight. Dress up goofy at school this week. Go to the games. Go to the cross-country meet. Have some fun this week and for the rest of the year. So what I'm asking is you guys, be real this homecoming and have a great time. Thank you.
Before we reveal who the king and queen are, let's watch the video to get to know the candidates better. Candidates, you may be seated in the audience.
Here we go back. This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up. Like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us. And we go back. This is a moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up. Like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us. Lady, my
job and head to New York City. This cowboy running from himself. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, hey, the way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me.
Meanwhile.
Golf.
It's not like I spend every day of my life here.
So you know what? We're gonna go hit some balls.
Got some 1919s. We're gonna go hit some balls now.
I'm ready. For this competition,
yeah.
Who's gonna hit it the farthest?
Obviously, man.
Obviously. Yeah.
Thank you.
homecoming court.
What do I know?
Mrs. Eisman in elementary school.
Miss Henkes from the elementary school.
I think I would have to say Miss Moody.
Moody, you're my teacher crush for homecoming, so I gotta give you some flowers.
Oh my god.
My teacher crush is Carrie Haugrud. Mr. Holt. Love for Mr. Holt.
Okay, my teacher crush is definitely Bill Simmons. Aww.
Oh no, this one's bad. This one's bad. During library in kindergarten, I peed on the floor during reading time. There was just like a wet puddle where I was sitting.
I have no idea. I don't think anything embarrassing has ever happened.
When everybody thought I was dead because I missed a month and a week of school because of a ski accident.
My most embarrassing moment in elementary is when Bryce Seiple asked me out by asking me, "What's your favorite track?" And then I broke up with him 3 days later.
When I raised my hand very politely in Miss Hoggard's class and asked if I could go to the bathroom, but we were playing a game of panda, and she told me no, so I peed on her floor and she had cleaned up with paper towels.
Yeah, what is this?
Nothing.
Take two.
Here we go.
What are you doing?
As our candidates return to the stage, let's review our festivities for the week. Tuesday is jersey and hat day. The girls' soccer team will be headed to St. John's Prep for a soccer match at 5 p.m. The boys' soccer team will be up against Bemidji at Bemidji High School at 5 p.m.
Wednesday is the Zoom day. Dress up or down, like you would for the Zoom day.
Thursday is Tacky Tourist. The boys and girls cross country team will be, I don't know where they're at. Home. The girls soccer team will be versus Walker at Walker starting at 4:30. The volleyball team will hopefully dominate the leaders gym against Perm at 5 p.m.
Finally, for Friday, spirit floating around the entire school. And to kick off the weekend, varsity football will be playing against Ardell Central at our home field starting at 7 o'clock p.m.
There will be a homecoming parade through town starting at 2 and ending at the high school. There will also be a tailgate celebration from 5 to 7 at Chauncey Martin Complex with games, bouncy houses, food, and fun.
That sure does sound like a fun week. Now, without further ado, let's meet our 2022 homecoming king and queen. Our crown bearer Mason will open the envelope revealing our king.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Now, Jada will do the same thing for the girls. Have a safe and wonderful night.